Hey guys, with LENOVO soon to release BIOS V28 update for Solution Go, I've had the beta version for over a week now and have been testing the new additions. You might have seen the 6400 versus 7500 MTS memory comparison we did last week. Instead, in this video, we are going to test out yet another new option called Thermal Policy, which can alternate between STT and STAPM, though it's worth noting that it's actually STAPM, not STAPM, which stands for Skin Temperature Aware Power Management. I guess the LENOVO team mistyped that. So anyway, if you wonder what they actually mean, basically STAPM is AMD's feature for APUs and mobile CPUs that gives a short performance boost as long as the device ergonomic limits allow that. Like not getting too hot to cause a disturbance when holding the Legion Go, for example. Instead, STT is a generic tracking method that monitors and manages device surface temperature and isn't linked to CPU or APU performance. So, we are going to find out the real difference by comparing both side by side to understand which one to choose. I'll be doing the comparison by conducting the test in two conditions. One with a TDP of 20W running the predefined performance mode without the Legion Go being plugged in into a power source. And the second is maximizing TDP all the way to 30W with the Legion Go plugged into power. Also, since we are talking about thermal here, I'll be comparing auto fan speed versus full speed for each mode. As for the type of testing load, it's going to be a casual Cyberpunk 2077 live gameplay for about 20 minutes running at 800p. But there will be also a bonus test for those more curious before the end of the video, so stick to the end. Before starting our first test, I want to note that in hardware info software, you can also monitor the APU STAPM, so throughout the test, pay attention to that specific metric. Something to note though, when you have STT, you can also monitor the CPU skin temperature internally. While with STAPM, this sensor gets disabled since skin temperature is being monitored dynamically on the APU to tune performance accordingly, and not by mainboard sensors anymore. Also in this video, for the first time, I'm going to put this new thermal camera I've got to take some exterior shots to check skin temperature other than internally in hardware info software. So with that being said, let's get over to our first test. As you saw, when I set the STAPM as a thermal policy, the APU STAPM isn't statically fixed but adjusted over time. It incrementally increased instead of the case of STT, which was static right from the beginning. As for battery consumption, it was the highest with STAPM with max fan speed. But as you can see, by only 1% difference, which could fall within margin of error. But theoretically saying, short performance burst could still potentially lead to higher power consumption. Now as for CPU temperature, we generally got slightly higher temps with the STAPM config at max fan compared to STT. As you see, 56.9 versus 57.9. So about a degree difference. In addition to the interior reports we have seen, looking at the exterior skin temp, the high point is right where the chip is located. With the STAPM max fan config, the high point is slightly higher, about 61 degrees versus 58.7. As for when we set the fan to auto, the difference in the high point is smaller, but we yet got a higher midpoint temp in STAPM. Looking at the performance results though, we see that STAPM with max fan is leading even by a small margin. Also, frame times indicate that as well. Now things will get somewhat interesting as we head to the 30W comparison. Let's check it out. In the 30-watt test, we again see higher temps with the STAPM config. Particularly, the CPU core with the fan on max is higher on STAPM compared to STT by about 3 degrees this time. Now heading to the exterior temp images we got, we see that STAPM with max fan speed high point is hitting 73.3 compared to 70 with STT max fan, with a midpoint also higher by about 2 degrees. So overall, the STAPM option seems to always have the tendency to get a slightly higher temp but not high enough to make the device unbearable to touch. It's just giving it a short performance boost while maintaining ergonomic limits. And that's confirmed also if we look at the FPS. Again, we see STAPM with max fan taking the lead with greater frame times too. Now the time has arrived for the bonus test I mentioned at the beginning. It's going to be a 3D Mark Time Spy running in 30 watt at 800p. So let's get to it. And here we are. For GPU, we got quite similar score for both STT and STAPM. However, for CPU, there is an increase of about 300 points in STAPM favor. And by looking at the captured data, we see it having some gains in both FPS and frame time. So in conclusion, choosing STAPM will probably give you a performance increase by allowing device to boost to a higher power state for a short period of time. But that comes also with a small increase in temperature, especially at higher TDP. But holding the device won't feel much warmer, as STAPM feature is made in a way to balance performance and thermal dynamically. So that was it for STT versus STAPM comparison. Now the real question, which one would you prefer to use? Let me know that in the comment section. I hope you found this video useful. Please subscribe to TechoSword to support this channel and be up to date with all latest content. Thanks for watching and see you in the next one.